Well, first of all, thank you for participation to our Burmese Canadian YouTube channel.
Of course, my pleasure.
We are giving some Canada information to the Burmese people who want to come to Canada or who want to study in Canada.
Okay.
Firstly, what did you study in Canada? Where did you study?
I went to the University of Victoria on Vancouver Island. I did my Bachelor of Science and I majored in psychology, and that was a 4-year program.
Yes.
And it took me about 4.5 years because I didn't do a full semesters, but it was a beautiful school and it was a small university compared to the big ones in Canada, so it was nice. It's beautiful there.
How long did you study, you said?
4.5 years it took me.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
What are the requirements for the psychology subject?
So the requirements to get into the university, I had to have all my sciences done in high school. So in grade 12, I had to have my math, biology, chemistry, physics, up to grade 12 level, as well
so
as...
So you finished high school in Canada too,
yes,
right?
Yes, I studied all in Canada.
So do you need to have a GPA, grade GPA?
The GPA, there was a requirement to get into this program. I now can't remember what it was.
Okay. It's okay.
But I was a good student. I had mostly A's. So it probably was above 80 for sure. 80%. Yeah.
So how is your study life like?
Studying in Victoria was...
အခုနားထောင်နေတာကတော့ Burmese Canadian YouTube page ဖြစ်ပါတယ်။တရီတာနိုင်ငံနဲ့ပတ်သက်ပြီးတော့စိတ်ဝင်စားတယ်ဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ကျွန်တော်တို့ရဲ့ YouTube ကို like and subscribe လုပ်ထားပေးပါ
။ Studying in Victoria was it was really fun as well as hard. The Bachelor of Science program requires you to take a lot more science classes. There's also an arts Bachelor of Arts in Psychology you can take as well, but science you kind of have to take more of like the neuro classes and all the biology, anatomy, and that kind of thing. But it was good, it was lots of fun, met lots of people, which is good. A lot of my best friends are from the island now, so I still keep in touch with them. It was good to move away from home to a new city and meet lots of new people.
So how is your psychology subject like? Is this too hard or quite okay?
Hard to understand because sometimes your brain doesn't think that way, but lots of memorizing, lots of different theories, and for the science part, it was tough, yeah. Like any neural classes to do with the brain, yeah, those classes were hard.
Why did you choose the psychology subject?
I chose psychology because, well, actually first I chose biology and I chose psychology as an elective. But as I started taking more psychology classes, I realized I was more interested in psychology because it's all about how people interact, why you do the things you do, what makes you you. So it's all about yourself as well as you could kind of study everyone around you and your relationships with them. So I thought it was quite interesting.
All right.
Yeah.
And also, why did you choose the Victoria University?
I chose Victoria because I'm from a really small town of around 10,000 people. So it's very, very small. There's no universities nearby. The closest one is already
away
2 hours away. I'm from the Okanagan.
Oh, Okanagan.
Very small town in the Okanagan. The closest university is about 2 hours away anyways. So I looked all over. I wanted to stay in BC, but UBC in Vancouver is very big. So I went to visit the campus. It's very, very small, but it feels very homey because it's not too big and you kind of, everything is within 10-minute walk. Every class, every building. So I don't know, it felt like a good choice. It felt like big but not too big.
So you live in Okanagan.
Yeah.
How is Vancouver? So where's the difference between your town and the Vancouver?
Yeah, so now I live in Vancouver. Quite the difference. I live in a very small town. There's it's totally different than here. Here's like a big city. Everything's busy. So much traffic, so much noise, so many buildings. Where I live, I think it's about 10 kilometers to either town. I live in the middle of nowhere. So it's a big adjustment, but I think everybody needs to move from a small town in order to see the world and see how things work, and of course get experience in whatever you're working towards.
Oh, what are the job prospects after your study with your subject?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I would like to continue to study. I would like to go back to school to do my master's in counseling and hopefully become a therapist and do therapy and more one-on-one counseling.
Mm-hmm. Okay, what further study do you need to do?
I need to at least get my master's.
Oh, okay.
Since I already have my undergrad degree, my BSc.
So you can be a counselor, mm-hmm. psychologist,
yeah.
Okay.
And if you want to go further, you can go back and get your PhD.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, what are your dreams and career?
Well, my dreams for a career is I want to work with the Indo-Canadian population, uh-huh. and provide psychologist needs. But I also understand that coming from such a different culture and environment, that the psychology that we study here doesn't always fit for immigrants and people like my parents and people like myself who kind of grew up with both cultures. So I want to study it further to make it more applicable to families that come from different cultures as well, and not just Canadian.
Oh, that's good. Mm-hmm. So, basically, you're a Canadian, so you don't need to worry about the permit and study visa.
No.
But you have another story too, right? So you have another difficulties because you're moving, right? You're moving. Mm-hmm. So what are your difficulties when you study?
Difficulties. Moving away from home was hard. I think that's going to be hard for anyone. And, adjusting. Well, because when I moved, I was only 17. So moving to a new area, learning how to live by yourself and cooking and all that kind of stuff, that was hard. But also, I think adjusting to the pace of school was hard because it's different than high school. Yeah. And when you live at home. So, all the responsibility is on you. Nobody's making you go to class. Nobody's forcing you to wake up early like your parents do when you live at home. So that was probably the biggest struggle for myself.
So how do you overcome if you see things?
I think overcoming it was because everybody around you is kind of in the same boat. So everybody around you is doing the same thing and waking up, going to classes. So you want to do it, and then you also realize the importance of it. So you realize, I have to do this because this is for me. I'm not doing this for anybody else. So once you kind of understand that your education is important for you and not for anybody else, it becomes more serious and you get a little bit more responsibility.
Okay. My second question, second part, mm-hmm. it's like you said, you're second child, second generation.
Yes.
What is it like to be a child of a second generation? What is it like to be a...
It was interesting growing up because my parents are both born in India. My family was all from India. So, growing up in a house where I'm born in Canada and all your friends are Canadian, but yet your parents are still accustomed to their, religious rules, and they're very Indian. It's an Indian household, so all their rules... But going to school, being raised with all these Canadian families and their rules, so it was quite hard because you didn't really understand where you fit, because all your friends are doing one thing, but you're not allowed to do some things, and all your friends.
And also, you have no idea why. Right?
No idea why. Yeah. You're like, but everybody around me is doing this. I'm born here too.
Yeah.
But you fit in, but you don't really fit in, especially in a small town, because everybody's. A little bit more small-minded. So growing up it was interesting, but even going to school, they really push for you to get a good education, good job, good this, high marks. So there was a lot of pressure always from family, but they always mean well and they want you to do well, and they're trying to give you the opportunities that they didn't have when they moved here. they didn't get the option to go to school or pursue any type of education. They just had to work, you know, to raise, make money and raise us, have a good, for us to have good opportunities.
Do you feel any advantages and disadvantages of being a second generation?
When
compared to the first generation?
Yes. The advantages definitely are that our parents worked really, really hard to send us to school and, you know, to pay for school, which are all opportunities that I wouldn't have had as a first generation. I would probably would have had a lot more debt and loans, had to work a lot harder financially, as well as like being born here, you know, you have the language and all of your education is done here. So adapting is a little bit easier to post-secondary school.
Okay. Do you see another differences between your parents' generations and your generation?
There's a lot of differences between my parents and myself. Because they were, you know, raised in a different country where every education is different for girls, rules are different for girls, what's expected of girls is different. Like, my mom by my age already had me, so she was already married, already had kids, so that was a big difference for sure. The education wasn't really like pushed for them.
Okay.
Yeah.
What are your good memories? One in your small town?
Small town? Definitely, I was lucky that I grew up around all my cousins. So it wasn't just my parents, but all of my cousins were all around the same age. So I remember growing up, any activity, whether it was going to the lake or going skiing on the mountain or whatever we did, it was all together. So that was really nice growing up.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
My last question is, do you have any memorable events while you're in university?
So many memorable events. UVic does, the school that I went to, University of Victoria, they have a really big like social culture, so they do a lot of events for the students. So almost every week there were different events put on either by the school or their sporting events that everybody would get together and go to. And I had a lot of friends that played on the sports team, so it was fun to go out and all support the school. Yeah.
Okay. Do you have any suggestion you want to come to Canada to study psychology subject?
I would suggest to keep an open mind, but to make sure that you stay on top of your work because it's easy to fall behind. And yeah, that's it.
Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
ဘုလိုနားထောင်ပေးတာကျေးဇူးတင်ပါတယ်ခင်ဗျာ။ကျွန်တော်တို့ Barmis Canadian Page က immigration lawyer, immigration consultant, လောက်ကန် agency မဟုတ်ပါဘူး။ကနေဒါနိုင်ငံမှာ immigration နဲ့ပတ်သက်ပြီးအဖိုးခါယူပြီးတော့အကြံဉာဏ်ပေးခြင်းလည်းဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ဆိုရစီမှာတရားဝင် register လုပ်ရပါတယ်။အဲ့လိုမှမဟုတ်ရင်တရားဝင်ပါဘူး။ကျွန်တော်တို့ကတော့ဒါတငယ်ချင်းတွေကထိတ်ဝင်စိတ်ဝင်စားနဲ့မေးမြန်းလာကြတဲ့အတွက် information တက်သက်ပေးခြင်းသာဖြစ်ပါတယ်။ကျွန်တော်တို့ကဥပဒေနဲ့ပတ်သက်တဲ့အကြံဉာဏ်ပေးခြင်း immigration နဲ့ပတ်သက်တဲ့အကြံဉာဏ်ပေးခြင်းမရှိပါဘူးခင်ဗျာ။